Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can display the current we measured from this shunt resistor up to 500 ampere using Arduino on this 4-digit LED display with TM1637. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. In continuing with my other videos to measure the current with a shunt resistor with Arduino, this is just to display the current that is measured with this on the LED 7 segment display with TM1637. I'm not going to explain all those details. You have to watch the introduction video for the shunt resistor if you want to know how it works. And also, I have another video explaining this TM1637 4-digit display, either this module or this. You have to watch that, install the library, make sure you are able to display something on the screen, some number. After that, come to this, because for this it will be very long to explain fully this one and this one, because I have separate videos. If you do not install the library, it will not work. And because the sensitivity of this shunt resistor when using it with Arduino is low, the decimal point doesn't have any meaning anyways. For that reason, when you are using it with this, the decimal point is discarded and we are getting a whole number. And here is a chart that it shows you for 50 ampere, 100 ampere, 200 ampere, 300 ampere, even 500 ampere shunt. If your Arduino is set with 10 bits, and these are the errors that you are getting. So make sure that any value below this will have no meaning. And this is the minimum value that you can measure with those shunt resistors. Because when we measure the voltage, the maximum voltage is 75 millivolts, and the 75 millivolts is representing 100 ampere. Especially if you have 200 or 400 or 500 ampere, the sensitivity will be reduced. Now, because with the 100 ampere, 75 millivolts is 100 ampere, and if you reduce it, the minimum that this can measure is around 4.88 millivolts at the input. For this value. Now, this 4.88 millivolts is representing 6.7%, which means anything below 6.7% will not be displayed. So this is now in 100 ampere, 6.7% will be displayed like zero. And this one has 0.5% error. And that means 0.5 ampere is only error in this one, plus the 6.5% that we have from the reading. For that reason, do not use this for less than 10 ampere. And if you're using 200 ampere or 400 or 500 ampere, the error would be greater. Now let me explain the wiring. I'm using electronic load as my load, where the power is connected to my electronic load. This is the electronic load DL3031, and these are the two terminals that from the circuit will be connected in here, and we will see the voltage here and the current. I'll be connecting it like this. My load is here. I will put this in series between the negative terminal and the load. If you want, you can also do it this way. I'm doing it this way. As you saw, this has been connected to electronic load. This is coming from my negative of power supply, coming and passing from here, and this goes to the negative terminal of my electronic load. these two points, I've taken these two wires. The side that is connected to the negative terminal of power supply is my negative, and this side is automatically positive. Here, that black wire is connected to this point, to ground, and the red from this side, this is a positive, this has been connected to analog zero. For this module, this pin 5 volts is connected to 5 volts. Ground is connected using this gray wire to the ground. And then we have data in out. White has been connected to pin 6. And then clock, CLK, have been connected to pin 5. And if you have this one, this is exactly the same VCC. Just the pins are there, but the VCC is connected to 5 volts. This will be connected to ground, and then clock is to pin 5. Data in out will be to pin 6. So this module, ground is connected to ground. VCC will be connected to 5 volts. And then we have data in out. And then clock will be to pin 5. Data in out will be to pin 6, exact same order. If you need a wiring diagram for this, it is available as part of my Arduino course at Udemy. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. You need to install the TM1637 library, but here quickly I will provide you the link with the zip file. Download the library, after that save it in your computer, and after that click off on sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then point it to where you have saved it. For example, if this was inside this folder, select that zip that you have downloaded the library and click open. It will be included, and then the sketch will work fine. Let me now explain the code. We are defining the N pin from the shunt resistor where we read the voltage, analog zero. And then this is a shunt current, either whatever value you have, 50, 100, 200, 300, 400, you just enter that value. As you can see, this is the 100 ampere, 75 millivolts, and this is the 50 ampere. So enter the proper value, 75 is the 75 millivolts, do not change it. And then this correction factor is just for the calculation purpose, do not change it. Minimum current is the amount of current that the system will ignore, because with this you cannot measure those values, so anything above 10 will be suitable, otherwise you will not get a proper reading. This is for the display, TM1637. We're defining pin 5 for the clock, pin 6 for the data in out. And to use it, this is how we use inside the loop. We use this display.showNumberDecimal. And here, get current. This is the value of the current. False means no zeros before the digit. Like in here, now we don't have any zeros before the actual number or value. And then four digits. Because we have three, I just put it four. The maximum current will be like 500, will be three digits. No decimal points, and then zero means start from this side, from here. If you put one, it will start from here, this way. And if you need full explanation of the code, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. Let me now demonstrate it. I've connected this larger display. The small is exactly the same. Currently, the current shows to be zero. This is my load, electronic load, and here is what we are reading. I've connected the 100 ampere shunt. Let me put 20 ampere and turn it on. As you can see, this is 20, and we are an average. That's how we read it. Because this is now discarding the decimal point. So let's go with 30. I've just changed it to 30. And let's go to 35. I change it to 35. I'm going now 40. Now this is the current that we are reading, and if I remove this, it goes zero. So we are reading 40 ampere. Let's go 50. And the current is 50, and we are reading this value here. Let's go 60. Now I've changed it to 60 ampere. And we are reading 60. If I go 10 ampere, because we are discarding the decimal point, this is what we are reading. Let's go to 5 amp, see if we can read it. So it goes between 0 and 5 because less than 10 is not recommended. And now let me disconnect this. And now I've connected this smaller display. Let's go 20. I changed it now 50. Just changed it to 50. As you can see, it is displaying exactly the same as the other one. So now I change it to 60. Let's go to 12. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this shunt resistor and measure the current and display it on the LED 7 segment display with TM1637 chip. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. And now let me demonstrate it. I've connected this display. It works exactly the same with this. Currently the current is zero. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description.